This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Monday the 9th of January. I'm Georgina White. Deputy Chief Minister calls airport tunnel financial disaster. Winner of local rock club singer-songwriter competition. Michael Prescott retires from Gibraltar National Dance Organization. Governor to visit new prison. And finally, Jamaica's Prime Minister vows to remove the Queen as head of state. Deputy Chief Minister Dr. Joseph Garcia has stated this morning that the airport tunnel is a disaster from a financial point of view. Dr. Garcia also noted that project costs for the newer terminal have been astronomical and the government have yet to make a decision on whether to shut it down until it is fit for full use. YGTV spoke to Dr. Garcia this morning.
Thank you very much for meeting with us on such short notice, Mr. Deputy Chief Minister. You went on the record to the Chronicle about the current situation with the tunnel works at the airport this morning. Could you tell us a bit more about the situation?
I think the first thing that needs to be made clear is that the tunnel, from a financial point of view, is an absolute disaster. That is to say, we have now been given an estimate that it's going to cost an additional £50 million, approximately about £50 million, to complete the tunnel, in addition to the money that has already been spent. And also, as you know, we may be facing a legal challenge from the previous contractor, OHL, in relation to the actions taken by the previous government, which now will obviously have consequences for the new government. So I can't say very much about that because obviously we don't know what's going to happen. But certainly from a financial point of view, I can say it is an absolute disaster.
Right. And on social media, there has been much speculation on issues such as the contracts awarded for maintenance of the new airport. Can you tell us anything about what these contracts could be costing the taxpayer?
Well, I can tell you really that the decision to open the new air terminal before it was complete has had a whole series of consequences, financial consequences, for the taxpayer. Obviously, it's more expensive to run two terminals than it is to run one terminal. I mean, from that basic point of view. But certainly there are some pretty extraordinary things that we've been uncovering, and one of them is that for less than a month, the cleaning of the new air terminal, we're expecting bills of in the region of £100,000. Now that is absolutely extraordinary, it's totally unacceptable, and it should never have happened. So really it would have made much more sense to have waited for the new terminal to be finished before opening it. And really the reason why the previous government decided to open it was purely and simply as an electoral stunt, because really were the terminal opened a month later or a month or 2 months later had no bearing on anything. It was only the fact that a general election had been called which led them to open the terminal for public viewings. So really we are extremely concerned by the things we have uncovered. We are trying to reduce the costs now in the new air terminal. We haven't taken a decision as yet whether it should be closed and we should wait until it's finished. We haven't taken that decision, but certainly we are scrutinizing very, very closely every penny that's being spent, and we're trying to reduce the amount of money that's being spent.
Local club Rock on the Rock held their second singer-songwriter competition. On the night, 9 local musicians participated in the contest. Judges Fabian Vinet, Luke Bossano and Daniel Gio chose Holly Buhaya's song Carousel as winner of the Best Lyrics Award, which was sponsored by The Chronicle. Holly also won first prize for the main competition. Second prize was awarded to Julia Varea and Karima Sopardi for their song It's OK. Third prize was awarded to Mr. Darcy for their song Unfamiliar. President of the Gibraltar National Dance Organization, Michael Prescott, has retired from his position of 30 years. Mr. Prescott, who was a founding member of the International Dance Organization, has led the Gibraltar National Dance Team in various competitions globally. Minister for Culture, Mr. Stephen Linades, has stated, "Michael and Deirdre Prescott have been pioneers of Gibraltar's dance for over 30 years, promoting Gibraltar internationally and achieving excellent dance results at international events." YGTV will have an interview with Mr. Prescott tomorrow. Minister for Justice, Mr. Gilbert Ligudi, has invited His Excellency, the Governor, Sir Adrian Johns, to visit the new prison at Windmill Hill tomorrow morning. Mr. Ligudi will accompany the Governor on his visit. And finally, newly elected Prime Minister of Jamaica, Portia Simpson Miller, has vowed in her inaugural speech to remove the Queen as head of Jamaica State. The announcement comes weeks before Prince Harry is set to visit the island. Mrs. Simpson-Miller announced, "As we celebrate our achievements as an independent nation, we need to complete the circle of independence. In this regard, we will therefore initiate a process for our detachment from the monarchy to become a republic with our own indigenous president as head of state." That's the YGTV News. I'm back tomorrow evening. See you then.